Hello and welcome to this video tutorial brought to you by tastyachieves.com. In this tutorial, I'm going to talk about colour and demonstrate some colour effects and tools in Adobe Illustrator. In Illustrator, there are many ways to use colour. It all really comes down to what exactly you're using colour for. For example, if you're creating artwork for digital and web, you will want to use RGB colours. And if you're creating artwork for print, you may wish to use CMYK colours. In some cases, you may find yourself using a Pantone book to reference colours, or a printer you wish to use will only require Pantones. In this video, I'm going to be covering swatches and Pantones, and discussing how you can customise and handle your colours for your specific task. Later, I will also be touching on gradients and transparency. To follow along with this tutorial, you will need to open this document I have prepared especially for this tutorial. This can be found in the Introduction folder, in the Project folder. Now, you can download this Project folder for free. The download link is in the description. So, with the Project folder open, click Introduction, Color Effects, Versions, and select the version of Illustrator you're using. In my case, it's CC, and open the Color Effect file, and you should have something that looks like this. Now, along the way, I'm going to be referencing particular panels here on the right. If you have been following this course from the start, you will be familiar with the way I have my panels structured here. In one of the early videos on this course, I demonstrated how to customize panels and create your own workspace. In my current workspace, I have all my color panels up here on the top for ease of access. If you don't have this, you can either skip back to my panels and workspace video and learn how to create this panel setup, or you can activate the panels as and when I mention them. Now, we're going to be covering a lot in this video and in quite some depth. If you wish to skip ahead at any point in this video or back, you can do so quite simply. The topics covered in this video are listed in the description along with their times, so be sure to check that out. So I'm going to begin by talking about some of the color panels in Adobe Illustrator we will be using in this tutorial. To make this really clear, I'm just going to click on each tab and drag it out here so you can clearly see them. I recommend you do the same. So here we have the swatches panel, the color panel, a Pantone panel, we have the gradient panel, and the transparency panel. If you don't see these panels, you can access these if you come to Window, and you can select them from here. Though you will not be able to get this Pantone panel from the panel list. I'll be talking about this a little later on. Okay, so first off, we have the swatches panel. Now, this is a handy panel where you can access some predefined colors. If you're new to Illustrator, your swatches panel will come with a bunch of predefined swatches, just like mine here. So here we mostly have some colors, but we also have some color effects too, such as gradients and pattern overlays. If you move your mouse cursor over your swatches, you will see the name pop up. Now, if you double click on a swatch, up will pop the options, and this window will tell you more details about the colour. In this instance, we have the colour mode of the document set to RGB, so this swatch is showing the colour mode of RGB, and here we can see the values. At this point, it's important to mention that currently my document colour mode is currently set to RGB. You can change your colour mode by coming up to the top menu and selecting File, scrolling down to Document Color Mode, and selecting CMYK or RGB from here. If you're doing work for web and digital, you will want to set to RGB, and if you're doing work for print, you'll want to set this to CMYK. If you change to CMYK, you will notice when you double-click on some of your swatches, it will display the CMYK values instead of RGB. So double-clicking in the swatches panel will show you the values. However, with a swatch selected, you will also see the color in your Tools menu. For example, I'm going to select a color from the swatch panel, and here we can see it in our Tools menu. Now, if you come to the square in the Tools menu and double-click this, a color picker option menu will appear. This will allow you to see the web color of that swatch, and here you could continue to select a new color from the color spectrum here. Adding colors to the swatches panel is very easy. For example, let's just click a colour here on the second artboard. Upon click, you will notice the colour appear in the Tools menu. If I want to save this colour for later, we can simply put our mouse cursor over the colour square, click and drag into the Swatches panel and release. And there is our new colour swatch on the end there. Easy. In the Swatches panel, you can also create and store swatches you make yourself as colour libraries. This makes it easy if you're working on a particular project and wish to save your colours. You can also export the libraries too and share them with others. If you look closely, you can see I have some folders here with some swatches I have prepared earlier. And I will be talking a little more about these later. So the Swatches panel is a pretty handy panel, and you will be finding yourself using this a lot as you create your artwork. Next, we have the colour panel. As you can see here, we have a complete colour spectrum, and if we move our mouse cursor over this, we will see the cursor change to an eyedropper tool, and this will allow us to choose a colour like so. Once we have the colour in mind, we can simply select it, and just like earlier, the colour will appear in the Tools menu. And if we like that colour, we can simply drag it into our Swatches panel. Next, we have a Pantone panel. This contains a library of solid coated Pantones. Now, this is not open by default if you're new to Illustrator. If you want this panel, you're going to have to open this separately. I'll be showing you a little later on how we can do this and how to incorporate these colours into our work. Next, we have the Colour Guide panel. Now, this is a handy panel if you seek to discover alternative shades and tints of a particular colour. For example, if I select a colour in the Swatches panel, notice how this colour guide panel changes. The top bar features the colour and shows some alternative shades and tints, and below are the colours around the same tone. This can be pretty handy if you're looking to research various tones and shades of a particular colour. Next, we have the gradient panel. If I go ahead and click on a gradient, if I click on a gradient object in my document, we can see this come to life. We are going to be using this a little later on and learn how we can use this gradient panel. And finally, we have the transparency panel. It's in this panel that we can control the transparency of an object on our document area. So before we begin, I'm simply going to close the Pantone panel, as I'm going to show you how to reactivate this later. Then click on all the other panel tabs and drag them into one panel group and reposition this along with my other panels here on the right, making sure to place it at the very top for quick access. Okay, so now you have been introduced to the panels, let's take a look at some examples. So with the document open, let's turn to the first artboard. So as you can see here, I have some pre-composed colours. On the left, I have some digital colours, and on the right, I have some Pantone colours. And as you can see here, I have listed the web and Pantone colour references. Now, at first glance, they look identical. These colours on the left look exactly the same as the colours on the right. But in actual fact, they are not the same. If we were to create a piece of artwork for print, and the printer required Pantone-only colours, then all the colours over here on the left would be unacceptable. Allow me to show you the difference. Now, with the selection tool, first click on the top left digital colour, this red one here, and look closely in the Swatches panel. You can see we have this red swatch selected. Now, select the red Pantone example to the right and notice how another swatch is highlighted in the swatch panel. Okay, so click back on the first example, come to the swatch panel and double click on it. We can see from the swatch pop-up option that this is a RGB colour and we can see the values. Click OK. Next, click back onto the Pantone colour and in the swatches panel double click on that. Now this time we have different values in the swatch options pop-up and we can see that this is a Pantone spot colour. Once again, click OK. So looking in the swatches panel, we can see two colour libraries. Now, at first glance, they appear to be the same, but in actual fact, they are different, and we would use these colours in different instances. Notice the colour library below has these little white tabs with a spot in. This is Illustrator communicating to us that these are Pantone colours, and are different from the other swatches. So, now we are on the subject of Pantones, I'm going to show you how you can find the Pantone panel. Some of you may use Pantone books to discover and reference your colours. Once you know your Pantone number, you're going to need to source it in Illustrator. So to do this, you need to come to your Swatches panel and come to the top right and click on the little menu button. On click, you will then need to come down to Open Swatch Library. When you roll over this, you will then see a large list of colour libraries. We are then going to come to Colour Books, and again we will see another list, and here we can see a series of Pantone colour books. So I'm going to go ahead and select the Pantone Solid colour book. Upon click, you will now see your new Pantone panel. If you know the number of your Pantone, you can simply click the number in the top to search for it. For example, I'm going to type in 802, and this will find the same green Pantone I have here. Excellent! So to discover many Pantones and get access to other colour books, you can use that technique. If you use Pantones a lot, you can simply drag your Pantone panel into your panels to the right, and that will remain there for quick access in future. Okay, so let's come over to the next artboard. In Illustrator, you can also source colours from images. If you take any photos for your design research or find images on the internet, you can simply place them into Illustrator and use the eyedropper tool to pick out colours from the image. So here is an image I have for you to have a go with. Below you can see some colours I have already picked out. So to do this, we first need to draw a shape on the document area. I have some shapes here I have created for you. You will need to first select a shape. So with the selection tool, I'm going to click on the first square shape, and if we look in the tools menu, we can see that this vector shape currently has a grey fill and no stroke. And we know this because the stroke colour has a red dash through it. Now come up in the menu and we are going to select the eyedropper tool. This is just around two-thirds of the way down here. Once you have this tool active, you will notice the mouse cursor change to the eyedropper. So now we are going to move our mouse cursor over into the picture and choose a colour we like. I'm just going to go ahead and click to select a colour. Upon click, the grey box will change to a colour. That particular colour that we just selected in the image. Pretty cool, right? So now I have a new coloured square vector, and the colour is currently selected in the tools menu. Now remember earlier with the swatches panel? If I like this colour, all I have to do now is simply click on the square in the tools menu and drag across and drop into my swatches panel, and it's there for me to use again later. So I'm going to press V on the keyboard to select the selection tool, and then I'm going to click on the next grey box. With the next grey box ready, I'm going to come to the menu and again select the eyedropper tool. This time, I'm going to come over to the image. Instead of clicking once, I'm going to click and drag over my image. Now, pay close attention to the colour in the tools menu. As you move your mouse around, you will see the colours changing in the tools menu. This is Illustrator giving you a prompt to what colour this is. This will make it easy for you to move around until you find a colour you're interested in. So once I find a colour I am happy with, I will release click and I will make the selection, and my square vector will change. Nice. So have a go at this and try and discover some new colours from the picture. Then once you are happy, move on to the next artboard page. So next we are going to talk about gradients. At this point, you will need to click on your gradient panel. In Illustrator, we can apply gradient effects to vectors. Here is one I have prepared earlier. With the selection tool, I'm going to press V on the keyboard. I'm going to select my circle with the gradient applied. Once this is selected, look in your gradient panel, and it's here we can see the details. We can see what colors make up the gradient and the values of distribution. It's here where we can modify the gradient. Now, we are going to create our own gradient here on this empty circle to the right. So first we need to select the circle with our selection tool, and an easy way to begin this is to come to the swatches panel. Now Illustrator comes with a predefined gradient, and we are going to find it and click it like so. So here we are with the gradient. Next we will want to reactivate our gradient panel so we can see the properties. Next, if we come to the menu here, we are about to use the gradient tool, and we can see this just above the eyedropper tool. If we select this, we now have a gradient bar on our shape. Now, this represents our gradient effect applied to our shape, and we are going to use this to adjust the gradient. So now I'm going to start to click and drag over my shape, and you will notice this will change the gradient direction and distribution. So once we are happy with the gradient, we can move our mouse cursor closer and over the line, and now we can see the colors that make up the gradient. If you are not happy with a color, you can simply click and drag it off. If you want to alter the distribution of a color, you can click on a tab and drag it along the bar like so. If I double click on one of the color tabs, up will pop a color picker menu. Notice to the left, you can activate your swatches and choose a swatch from this. So I'm going to just alter my gradient until I have something that looks like this. Now, if I look on the gradient panel to my right, I can do a couple of things here. If I want to, I can alter the type. I can change this from linear to radial. And if I come just down to the left here, I can click on the reverse button and that can reverse my gradient like so. So that's a little intro to the gradient effect. Now finally, I'm going to talk about transparency. And this is an effect you may wish to use. For this, you will need your transparency panel open. So here we have two circles and you can see they are overlapping in the middle. We have this effect because the top object is transparent, showing some of the circle below through it. At any point, if you click on an object, you can see its opacity in the transparency panel. And I have my panel open here. With the selection tool, I'm going to select the first circle on the left. And if we look in the transparency panel, we can see the opacity of the circle is 50%. If I want to toggle the opacity, I can simply type in the value or click the drop-down menu to select a value from there. So I'm going to click this and select 80% like so. Next, I'm going to select the circle to the right and we can see this is set to 20%. I'm going to go ahead and change this to 70%. So that is how you can toggle opacity in Illustrator. So that's an introduction to color in Adobe Illustrator. Be sure to get comfortable with the color panels, as that will improve your workflow and assist you to use the right colors for the right task. In the next video, I'm going to cover 10 details in Adobe Illustrator that you should know and be up to speed with before starting a project. The things I'm going to cover in the video are things that are going to improve your workflow and help you create your artwork. See you in the next video.